Pro golfer Tiger Woods made headlines last week, but unfortunately it was not for his golf game. Woods was arrested for DUI near his home in Jupiter. However, he had not been drinking. But to better help us understand Florida's substance laws and driving under the influence is our forensic scientist and attorney, Anne-Marie Rizzo from The Law Place. All right, Anne-Marie. Tiger was reportedly found asleep, and then when they took the test, he got a DUI, but he blew zero. How does this work?
This is actually something that has become very common, and why I decided to become a forensic lawyer scientist, because of prescription medications. We see it all over the place, and we're never going to really know a lot of answers here. They took a urine test to determine what was in his system.
Okay.
But the urine is kind of like our dumpster. It's not going to show anything he was actively under the influence of. It's only going to show something that he has taken in the past.
Oh.
So we may not really know the answers. Your urine results can show things from 2 to 3 days prior, potentially. As some people may know with marijuana, it stays in your system for a long time. Doesn't mean that you took it that day. So we're going to have some issues from the state's perspective in prosecuting this case. The other real issue with it is Ambien. There's a lot of speculation as to what medications he was on. There's rumor that there was Vicodin. There's rumor that he was taking other meds that are not FDA approved, but are also not controlled substances. So in Florida, you have to be under the influence of a controlled substance defined by statute. Ambien is not one of those.
Oh.
It's a very dangerous drug.
So Ambien is not a DUI drug.
That's correct.
Interesting.
But you said it's dangerous.
It is very dangerous. I mean, even as a defense attorney, I would say that Ambien is still one of those drugs that should probably be on that list. It shouldn't actually be on the market, period. It can be very, very dangerous depending on the person and how their bodies react.
Because it lets you sleep or almost like sleepwalk?
Imagine sleepwalkers or people who talk in their sleep. You can have conversations with people who are completely asleep, but they seem to be awake. They're talking to you or they're walking. You know, my uncle will actually go to the refrigerator and make himself a glass of milk and eat snacks and be in a complete sleep interact. And people who are under the influence of Ambien can do the same things. Mm-hmm. Everything in that video of his DUI arrest is very symptomatic to Ambien. And although we don't know if that was the case, I wouldn't be surprised if it comes back that he was under the influence of Ambien. Now, we know he's had those back surgeries and he was taking those meds as well, but that may show in the system, but doesn't necessarily prove the DUI if we do have evidence that he was taking his Ambien as well.
Here's my
question. What will happen to him if it's Ambien?
Well, I mean, that's going to be up to his good defense lawyer. So, I mean, he's going to have that defense team that's going to really need to be able to put on the experts and be able to argue that. I myself have tried that in a jury trial and had jury verdicts come back not guilty because they couldn't decipher what it was impairing the person.
Mm. Wow.
Here's my question, though. He wasn't driving. He actually was asleep. So, you know, when you think of driving under the influence, you think of a person actually weaving through traffic and moving the car. How does that work?
Why is it illegal to be asleep on the side of the road?
Yeah.
So you're in actual physical control of the car. So at any moment, the law will say that you can drive. You can start that car and drive, and you're still under the influence. So if the keys are anywhere in the car, you're in actual physical control of the vehicle.
Wow, even not in the ignition. I think people might have thought that was a loophole.
But I've heard where you're supposed to put it in the trunk.
I've heard that. Well,
and that
would be a good defense because technically you don't have the ability to immediately drive away. You know, I've had people who've been guilty of DUI technically because they left the bar, knew they had too much to drink, and just slept it off in the parking lot.
Oh.
You know, it happens, and our law is technically in or on the vehicle is considered actual physical control.
Wow. So should you give the keys to someone back in the bar if you decide you need to sleep it off?
Yeah.
I mean, because it's kind of a responsible choice to sleep it off.
I think so. Right. Yes, to pull over if you think you can't drive.
Right.
You want to encourage those behaviors, but by the same token, you need that law for the people who fall asleep at a traffic light.
Right.
Okay, so it's too hard to carve out all the exceptions, unfortunately, for the legislator. So, you know, you have to use judgment, and that's where the prosecution and the defense are going to need to work together on this. Now, the damage to his vehicle doesn't help.
Yeah.
It does show that there may have been some problems maneuvering his vehicle at some point. And they have to maybe prove where that happened if it wasn't pre-existing, which could be a problem. He has a right to remain silent, so the state's got to put on all that evidence, and they've got to find this. In Palm Beach County, they have their own lab that will do all the toxicology. So this is not the last we'll hear of this. When his urine results come back with all the results in it, we're going to hear about it. And it'll be kept in-house in Palm Beach County, more than likely through their sheriff's office. Here in Sarasota, in our local area, it actually either goes to Tallahassee or Orlando, and we have to wait for those results to come back, which usually takes about 60 days.
Wow. Well, this is a definitely an interesting case.
Wow, I've learned something.
Yeah. Yeah. Have a lot of
over and go to sleep.
Well, if you guys have any legal questions, well, they have the answers. You can actually go to Anne Marie's website, the Law Places website, and get all of your information that you need from them or contact them. Next, when we come back, we'll show you some of our moments from Walt Disney World. We'll be right back.